Hello and welcome to the Pembroke College Barkathon 2022. My name's Anna Lapwood and I'm the Director of Music here at Pembroke College. I've been running the Barkathon for 6 years now, and normally this is an event that fundraises to support musicians in Zambia. However, this has not been a normal year, and so our fundraising this year will be supporting the people of Ukraine. We're hoping to raise £10,000 for the Disasters Emergency Committee, and there should be a little fundraising link in the description of this video. Anything you can give would be much appreciated. The event itself is bringing together 70 organists this year from all over the world, and we're particularly excited to be starting with the world's largest organ, played by Felix Hell. Here's Felix to introduce it.
Hi friends, my name is Felix Hell and I'm a concert organist from Germany, currently residing in the United States. And some time ago, Anna sent me a message asking if I would be interested in participating in her Bachathon 2022. And of course, I was more than happy to accept the invitation, and here we are today. I happen to be the lucky devil who gets to play Toccata and Fugue in D minor by Bach, and my immediate thought was, how can you present this piece in a way that it may not have heard before? Why not perform one of the most iconic pieces of classical music on one of the most iconic instruments in the world? And that's the instrument you see behind me. I reached out to my friends at the HORC here in Atlantic City and asked them if we could use this organ to record this piece, and they were super generous and welcoming and extremely accommodating in making this possible. This is a Midmerlage organ from the year 1929, and it was completed in 1932. It has 33,000 pipes, 449 ranks, and 7 manuals. It is an absolute beast, but a beautiful beast, I might add. At the moment, it's being restored. It's been an ongoing process. Only about 53% of the organ is currently functioning, which is still 240 ranks. So I hope that with this performance today, you will get to experience Toccata and Fugue in D minor in a way that you may not have heard it before.
Thank you. My name is Jong Hee-yeon. I'm from Seoul, South Korea. I'm in the master program at East Carolina University. This is St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Greenville, North Carolina, where I'm organ scholar. And this organ is CV Fisk, Opus 126. The nickname is Duchess.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Gavin Phelps and I'm playing three Bach pieces on the Bath Abbey Kleist organ. The first piece I'm playing is it Rusu Dir, Jesus Christ, BWV 639. The next piece I'll be playing is Prelude and Fugue in C from 8 Short Preludes and Fugues. The next piece I'm playing is Erschienen ist der Heilige Tag, BWV 629.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Tim Patient from Norwich, and I play the organ in various churches in and around the city. For this recital, I'm very fortunate to be in the Octagon Unitarian Chapel, playing the organ originally built by Michael Crotch in 1802, and then rebuilt by local Norwich firm Norman and Beard in 1899. And I would like to give my thanks to the members and leaders of the Octagon Chapel for letting me record here. The first pieces I'm going to play are four choral preludes, the first two of them for Christmas, the third one for the end of the year, and then the final one is an Easter one. Christum wir sollen loben schon, and wir Christen leut, BWV 611 and 612. Helft mir Gottes Güte preisen, BWV 613, and Jesus Christus unser Heiland, BWV 626. And then I will play the Dorian Toccata and Fugue in D minor, BWV 538.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello and welcome to the chapel here at the Queen's College in Oxford. My name's Charles Francis, and although I'm here in Oxford today, I actually hail from Birmingham. I'm an undergraduate student at the Royal Birmingham Conservatoire and also organ scholar at the Cathedral. It's always a bit of a lottery entering the Barkathon because you're never quite sure what piece you're going to get. However, on this instance, I feel very lucky with my allocations. I'm going to be starting with one of Bach's chorale preludes from the Neumeister collection, which is Jesu meine Freude, which is perhaps a work that we think dates from Bach's student days. He was known in his younger years for being very elaborate with his chorale accompaniments, to the point where he'd often confuse or sometimes leave congregations feeling quite lost. And the decoration and the vigour and the contrast that he gets in the setting of the chorale really brings us across well. I'm then going to be continuing with another chorale prelude, and that's her Jesu Christ durch uns wend, which is something along the lines of "Turn to us, Lord Jesus Christ." This is what we call a pulpit chorale, which would have been sung just before the sermon in a German Lutheran service. So this chorale prelude comes from the Leipzig collection, which was published in Bach's later years, although we reckon it uses material from earlier on, particularly around the period when he was court organist in Weimar. The last stanza particularly discusses the Trinity, and so his rather forward-thinking use of a trio texture within a chorale setting perhaps is a bit of a number reference to this. It's apt that we started with a work that was probably from Bach's student days, that we now finish with his Sonata 5, which, as a student of his comments, was written principally, or he thinks anyway, for Wilhelm Friedemann Bach, his son, to help him become a great performer and test his technique both musically and also virtuosically. This is a great sonata, and it's a lot more instrumental than the other ones. You really get this kind of concerto feel with this tutti first movement, and then a beautiful dance-like largo, the second movement, where time almost stands still. And then finally, this very fugal, lyrical style final movement, which feels really light and jumpy 2-4. So Bach, Bach, and Bach. And before I start, once again, I just want to thank Anna Lapwood for organising this and allowing me to take part. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Ben Tutor and I'm one of the organists here at the Metropolitan Tabernacle Baptist Church in central London. This church was founded in around 1650, making it one of the oldest Baptist churches in the country. And in the 19th century, the most famous Baptist pastor of them all, Charles Haddon Spurgeon, began his ministry. He was only 19 when he became the pastor. When Spurgeon died in 1892, the church had become the largest nonconformist church in the world. Today, the congregation numbers around 1,000, and we need an instrument with plenty of heft and power to accompany the very hearty singing. And so the instrument we have here is a three-manual Vicam. Sadly, the church was bombed in the Second World War, and the architect who oversaw the rebuilding didn't allow any space for a pipe organ. So we have to had to contend with a succession of electronic instruments. Thankfully, this one is a very good one. This church is unusual among many Baptist churches in that we hold exclusively to traditional worship. So the instrument behind me is the only one in the whole building. There are no drums, guitars, anything like that. And there are very solid biblical reasons for holding exclusively to traditional worship, as well as musical ones. The first two pieces I'm going to play to you are both from the Orgelbuchlein. Both of them are Christmas chorales. So the first one is Gott durch deine Güte, and the second is In Dulce Jubilo, and both of them have rippling figurations in the manuals, with the tune in the soprano part and the tune followed in canon in the pedals on the reed stop. After that we have Ehre sei dir Christe, which is one of the Neumeister chorales and is constructed a little bit like a fugue. After that we have the crowning glory of Bach's musical offering. Bach was invited to play to Frederick the Great of Prussia. In fact, his director of music was Bach's own son, C.P.E. Bach. Frederick gave Bach, the elder Bach, a very difficult theme upon which to improvise. Bach, as you can imagine, did an amazing job. He then presented Frederick the Great with this compendium of trio sonatas, canons, ricercars, and so forth, based on his theme. And this six-part ricercar takes the theme and constructs an enormous piece of Baroque musical architecture with it. It's one of Bach's greatest works, and one of the greatest, indeed the greatest, one of the greatest works in the Western classical repertoire.
Hi, my name is Cadence Broussard. I'm 13 years old from Ontario, Canada, and I will be playing three pieces out of Bach's Orgel Buch line, BWV 609, 625, and 631, on the Metropolitan United Church's 1930 Casavant et Frères pipe organ, which is widely known for its romantic voicing and being the largest pipe organ in Canada.